hammerhead.
Big hammer.
Big T-bone. Big hammerhead. That is a big hammer. Woohoo! And there's his jump. Right on cue. Yay! Oh, mate, that's awesome.
This episode of the ITM Fishing Show, New Zealand's most awarded and celebrated fishing show, is made available for you to watch right here for free, thanks to our mates at ITM. Good buggers, eh?
We're on a shark odyssey, travelling around New Zealand and checking out the sharks that we share our coastal waters with, as well as getting up close to study their behaviour. We're catching some sharks to get DNA samples and attach research tags. And to catch sharks, we need bait. And there's no better bait than fresh tuna.
Oh, got him on this one.
This could be the precious bait that we want because we're going to try a little bit of live baiting. Hoping we've got a skippy on here. Albacore sort of saw. Live bait nonetheless. Yeah, okay, Wayne, we'll go and set up a drift, eh? We'll go and sit on that bait, eh? Start chumming. Off you go, Mr. Albacorosaur. You want to point that way, point that way. Off you go. Oh, here he goes, just woken up.
Water's pretty good, eh?
It's pretty blimmin' good, all right. Mate, look at that fella. We've got him out there kicking the vibe out for us. Now, what we're doing here, this process, is called chumming, which is like burleying in essence. And what I'm doing is I'm chopping up chunks of our albacore tuna, which is naturally already quite an oily fish. But to make it more oily, we're adding it to this brew that Pete's just ladling over the side here. And all these chunks are going to soak up that oil. And as we throw them out over the side, all the oil's going to come out of them and sink. So if you can imagine, we're drifting along this way. As they sink down, they're releasing that oil, and we're burling right through the whole depth of the water column. And we just got to keep it steady, make it last, and it's like a crumb trail, if you like. The old fairy tale Hansel and Gretel, they'll follow it right to us, except there won't be no gingerbread house. Holy smoke. Oh, he's seen it now. Jeez. We're just filming some burleying shots, and the shark, rather than coming to our bait, goes straight to Blair. It's good to know.
Good to know we were watching.
Imagine, see, we wouldn't have even got a shark up if we didn't have Blair that is burly in the water.
See that shark?
Oh, yeah. He's not in great shape as our live bait. The old blue sharks, back in force. This could be a bit of a nuisance. Although, the blue sharks are still part of this research program, so perhaps we should get some tags into some, because blue sharks, of all the sharks, travel the greatest distances. Their design, their long, slender profile, that long top tail lobe, just makes them very efficient at covering the vast oceans of the world. So it's amazing, some of the blue sharks tagged in New Zealand, the distances they've covered, literally halfway across the world they'll go. So we'll put some tags in some of these sharks shortly. It'll be interesting to know where they turn up. Okay, now we've got a rather larger blue shark here, but what I'm more interested in is the albacore and the skipjack are like coming up right amongst the sharks, and they're actually competing with the sharks for burley. Now, normally you'd think a tuna, which these sharks are well capable of eating, wouldn't be anywhere near the sharks, but of course albacore tuna and skipjack tuna are far too fast for the blue sharks. If these were Marcos, it would be a different story. They'd be able to catch those albacore tuna, and if you watch those cubes, if a shark doesn't eat it, I'm sure a tuna will. You can see there's a nice size albacore out there. Just watch the cube. Oh, he ate this one right here. Okay, here goes a cube. There's our albacore, mate. Stay with that cube. Here he comes. Oh, he's seen it. Is he going to beat it? Who's going to win, the albacore or the shark? Oh, the shark's going to get it. Dang. Now, with these little tunas down here, I've got that, which is exactly what they're eating, which is just little chunks of tuna, in fact. So the trick is for me to be able to feed that to a tasty tuna as opposed to one of those sharks. You have to keep an eye on it though. Don't want a shark to get it. Oh, something's grabbed it. Yep. Oh, don't now. I've got to worry about the shark swimming into my line. Oh no, that was around the shark's fin then for a second. Woohoo, look at that. It's smoking. Who said you can't have a little bit of fun
and you're out doing some serious shark research, and perhaps get yourself some dinner at the same time, catching tuna on this light snapper tackle. Although I haven't got them in yet, there might be a few sharks that might want to eat them. This gear is so smooth, you barely know you've got a funny fish on there, that you're winding line. It is silky smooth. Oh, look at that go. You can't even hear that, it's so smooth. Have I said it's smooth? Now, I don't want to sound defeatist, but there's a good chance I won't get this tuna in, because in case you haven't noticed, there's a few sharks around here. So it's just kicking out those vibes, and it might bring us in a Mako shark, which is far more of a predator, rather than a sort of ocean scavenger like these blue sharks are. Mate, there's one. How many sharks are there now? Five.
Four or five, mate.
Yeah. They're all our little mates now. The sharks have kind of been with them, you know, most of the day now. Sharks are our friends, actually. They get a bad rap. There's the old shark. Tuna's going into his circling rhythm, which they typically fight in. Big, wide circling arcs. There he is. It's an albacore. Look at that. Beautiful. And no doubt that albacore can see the sharks too. He's probably not terribly impressed. Far out, I can't get him up. Mate, I just love their swimming style, the tuna. Uh-oh. Oh, jeez. Crikey Dickens. You got him, Pete?
His tail, mate.
Yeah. You beauty. What do you put there? It'd be a few kilo?
Be a fiver.
Five or 6 kilo? I mean, that there is what the commercial guys that troll lures, that's exactly what they're after. They are a great eating fish, and look at that amazing big long petrel fin, and it just folds into that recess, and it can turn itself into a bullet. Now, of course, with these petrel fins being so long, if they see a bait fish or something, pow, they throw that one out, it creates drag, and they can turn on a dime. Look at the colour of it, it's amazing.
Oh, hammerhead.
Big hammer.
Big T-bone. Big hammerhead. That is it. Big hammer. Woohoo! And there's his jump. Right on cue. Yay! Oh, mate, that is awesome. We hope you enjoyed this classic episode. But if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app. Oh, you got a full string of them. Bring them over here. Swing them over here. Look at these baits. They're awesome baits. Whoa, big shark. Holy smokes, it's a big shark.
Hammerhead.
Big hammer.
Big T-bone. Big hammerhead. That is it. Big hammer. Look at him. Go, Wayne. Go, Wayne. Go. Just go. Okay, we're going to need to get one of these straight on. There's a live bait. Look at the size of him. Oh, he's a bit split. He's wound up all right. Get in the water, player! Get in the water! That is an awesome shark. That is a big T-bone, bro. That is a big T-bone. Yeah, bro, if you're happy going in, you go in. The old T-bones, mate, they're sweet, mate. Go. Look at the size of him. Yeah, there he is. He's just hanging back a little bit. They're notoriously shy, the hammerheads. And in fact, they use that big hammer, that front dome, like a sonar. And they scan the water, they're swimming motions like this, and they're trying to pick up senses of bait fish. Now, in the past, when we've seen these big hammerheads and tried to catch them, of course, they've got big razor sharp teeth. We're using steel trace. The trouble with steel trace is the hammerheads don't seem to take bait with steel traces, so we've got to go to mono and just hope that it holds on. That's why we're using this big, thick, strong mono and a circle hook. That is an awesome shark! Oh, man. Now, one of these mackerel that Wayne's just caught, that the hammerhead shark was so interested in, is going to go right back in, although this time it's going to be rigged up, and hopefully it'll get the interest of the hammerhead once again, because it would be awesome to get a tag into that specimen and a fin clipping, although it would be pretty interesting trying to snip his fin, wouldn't it?
Do we have to? Truly? I'd say that we didn't.
Give it a minute, and if he doesn't come back, man, I say we get Blair out of the water.
Oh yeah, that big hammerhead was pretty shy. He came in, but he was just ghosting in from a distance. He didn't really want to come up like the markers
did. Oh, you've been eating, mate.
What's that? Oh yeah, Marco's just after this bait right here, look, right next to the boat. Oh yeah, oh he's hot on that bait. and the bait all of a sudden wants to be back in the boat.
I want to be back in the water.
You see, that's not a normal response. Shark turns up wanting to desperately hop into the water. Very few people have this condition. Look, there he is. Is he after that bait? Has he got that bait? He's after it. Oh, look, he's right after it. Look, the bait's coming back at the boat again. Here he comes. He's coming up on that live bait. He's really sussing it out. Seeing what's the story with this boat. What's going on there? It's the old trick. He's popped the boat off. He's going to jump right up at your tuck. Oh, no, he spat it.
Hooked at the back of the fin.
And the fin, oh, he rolled round on it and got the fin.
He just did some rolls as soon as he
fell. Oh, okay, well there you go. I mean, that happens. He rolled up, he felt the hook, but I mean, that's probably not a bad thing. It's got rid of that Marco and it's cleared the way for that big hammer, which is, there's such a timid shark, the hammerhead. Such a timid shark. Well, there you go. There's our jack mackerel, and that's just what a brush with a small Marco's teeth will do. He has just annihilated that. Big shark, big bait. Now, go off that way, buddy. There you go, just kick around. Right. Well, it looked like a blue shark tail. Yeah, it looked like a blue. I might wind that bait up. Oh, no, something's got it. He's got the bait now, look. You can see him thrashing around.
Gone and hooked the bloody door, have we? Hope not.
Yeah. He's after it. Look at him, he's after it. Is it a Marco? Oh, yeah, I know, that's a big blue. That's a blue. Bloody blue. Bloody, here it is. Well, are we going to catch him or what?
Apologies, gentlemen.
Yeah. What are we going to do? If he wants it, he's hot. This guy will hang around now, I'd say. We're probably better off free tagging him. And one, two, three. Ah, tagged. See, barely flinched the bugger. Well, we got our tag in, which is great, but the shark that we wanted to sort of scare off is kind of still here, like as in right there. So, there you go. Apparently getting a stainless steel barbed tag put in your back doesn't really bother you too much if you're a shark. Which makes sense because they do, in fact, have no cerebral cortex and they don't have fear and anxiety and pain like we humans do. However, some humans, probably with a not such a good mental capacity, tend to project human emotion onto fish that are large. It's called affection for charismatic megafauna. I mean, I love sharks, but I love them in a way that I've got respect for them, not that I think that they're cuddly teddy bears.
It's not his tail that you pulled up towards me. Be careful of the pointy end.
Yeah. That is one game fish there that has got a tag in it that hasn't been hooked, which is a bit of a rarity really. Nice one, there he is, I see him. That's a stunning looking fish.
Got it.
Is that the Marco?
Yeah.
Good work, Wayne. There you go. Bit of research right there, bro. Yeah, fight time, 5/10 of a second. That's half a second. See? We're just moving away from our burley trail now. The blue sharks have really sort of turned up in force, so we're trolling live baits where we're less likely to catch a blue shark and more likely to get one of the more predatory sharks like the Marco. Or a big hammerhead shark that we know is around here somewhere. So look, I like this. Like having a couple of nice baits out, you really feel like you're fishing.
Yeah, see them.
Oh, skippies everywhere here. I'm getting hit. Got them on. Small if it's a skippy. There you go. You just see some skipjack tuna or some sort of fish. So we're trolling our baits around. So I cast out a soft plastic, first cast, bumper. We've got a net handy, eh? Oh, kahawaka. That's the way.
Right.
Big fatties.
We'll get them rigged straight up, hey?
Oh, he's on it. Come on, you punk, eat it.
Could be swimming towards us. One now, it might be coming up on our plate.
Nah, I'm coming tight. Oh, no, just let it go.
Round up,
do you want to maybe, you can get that bait in, eh? We don't want to get that one, do we? He's too small, eh? Look at him, he's right there, look. Look at that. Even at that size, look at the size of him. And that little gnarly as Marco has just nailed. Oh, look at him, he's smashing it. Look at him. He's got a taste for it. He's taken the tail off, which is what they do to. Oh, jeez. Look at him, he's just so aggressive. Look at them. And look what he's done. First off, he comes up to this kawai and he takes the tail off to immobilize it. And you can see just by grabbing it and lashing it around, that's his bite radius. So not a very big shark at all. But you can see he's just mashed through, right through that bone, that hard backbone there. Mate, gives you an idea what a big one can do, eh? Marco on the scene, gang. He's coming to look at Blair. He's coming straight in to look at Blair. Ooh, straight in to look at Blair. Woohoo! Yeah, boy. Feed this one a bait on the Stella, eh?
Yeah, mate.
We're all about catching the sharks. Okay, we've got this Marco shark eating our cubes of chum. So I've rigged up this rig here. You'll notice the style hook, it's got a very small gape. It's a recurve hook. That's how it's gonna hook them in the corner of the mouth. Of course, we don't wanna harm them if we're gonna be tagging them and releasing them, because of course, a dead fish is no good at all for research. So I'm just gonna float that down there and we're hoping he's just gonna come along and pick it up. There he goes, he's got the bait. He's picked it up. I'm just letting him sort of get it in. And then I'll close that bail arm. And then as I put tension on, it will roll that hook, that should get him in the corner of the mouth. And once he realizes that that hook's in the corner of his mouth, that's when he can light up and jump. Marcos are notorious jumpers. And when they've hooked, they've in fact jumped into boats on occasion. And he's showing his speed now, there he goes. And there's his jump. Right on cue, yay! Oh mate, that's awesome. That's what these, hey! There he goes, that's what these things are capable of. Oh, there he goes again. Just gonna keep going. Oh, hey! Oh mate, that's awesome. Now that's what I mean by explosive power. Look at that thing just backflipping around the place. He's landing upside down and moments later he's back in the air again. I mean, just the acceleration to land so awkwardly, right yourself, and within the space of a meter or so, he's propelled himself way up into the air. I mean, that is impressive, but believe me, you want to see a 300 or 400 kilo one doing that. It's the old snipper pickering a little bit. there's some soft gloves there as well, if you want another pair of gloves. No, no. Oh, am I going to go under or am I going to go over Blair? I'm going to go under him.
Decision made.
Yeah. Crisis averted. Here he comes. He's actually not a bad size.
No,
not bad little rat. Gate. It's all you, Wayne. You go get that tag in him, Petey. Perfect tag placement right on that cartilage, and you see he's not going to be terribly happy about this. I mean, what I'd like to do is better just give you a little look at the anatomy of the Marco shark. I mean, you look at that point, this shark comes to a point, he turns into a bullet. Now what we've got to be careful of is, while he's pointing towards us like that, you saw him jumping, if he flicks his tail, he'll propel himself, well, that's why we're kind of pointing him away, he can propel himself into a boat. Check out those teeth, those razor sharp teeth. They are one of the sharpest things you can possibly get. They're like a surgeon's scalpel. I've seen them brush up against the side of other fish, big fish like swordfish, and just tear them to shreds. But what I've got to do now is just somehow get a hold of one of his fins and just take a wee, whoa, don't like him pointing at me like that, and just get a wee clipping. If you can keep his head around that way, I might just be able to pop down the ladder a little bit. We can afford to take our time with a Marco of this size, because while it's strong, we've probably got the measure of him as far as strength goes, but we've still got to be very careful and give him plenty of respect. Got the sample, beautiful, right. Okay, and away. He's away. Because we've got him upside down, you'll notice he's in shark tonic, which is like a state of being stunned. Now,
As he drifts down and he rights himself, you'll see that he'll come into a state of consciousness and he'll swim away. Go down after him, Blair. See if you can right him and he'll swim away. He's righted himself and he's away. So there you go. Blair will have that on film now. I think that was a success. Because we got that. Cheers, boys. Thank you, Wayne.
Thank you, mate.
Mad skills. Now let's get one like that, just bigger.
Yeah.
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode. But if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.